This is really pretty simple. I've been watching you for a while because ever since you took this role, you remember when you backstabbed me and grabbed it? I thought you actually might do a pretty good job because unlike anybody else that's been in that role before you, you're pretty much spineless and gutless. And you're not very swift. And I didn't think that you would see the obvious grab for power that lay in front of you, but I was wrong. See, you are no different than anybody else, really. Actually, you are quite worse than anybody else. You tried to use the role to make yourself a star.
Hunter, I really respect your opinion, and I respect you, but you got it all wrong. That's not what I was doing.
Johnny,
I've
Johnny?
Done a lot of good things for Raw. You can ask them. I've done a lot of good things.
Don't lie and make it worse now. When Vince ran Raw, he let personal decisions cloud his judgment, and he had to be replaced. When I ran Raw, I let personal decisions cloud my judgment, and I had to be replaced. You have let personal decisions cloud your already questionable judgment numerous times.
Hunter, please. Please don't do this, okay? I'll do anything. I'll do anything to save my job.
Hold on a second. Wait, you were cheering. What did you say, the last thing?
I said I'll do anything to keep my job.
I'll do anything. Wow. That's a broad statement. It's one of your problems in executive position, Johnny. You're kind of vague with direction. That leaves a lot to interpretation. Anything. What if I do what you did to CM Punk a few weeks ago and I make, let's say, a gauntlet match, and I go back there and I ask every WWE superstar that wants to take a whack at you to come to this ring
and
form a Congo line and whack the crap out of you.
Come on, Hunter. Come on. I'm not ready for that.
Listen, I'm not going to do any of this silly stuff. I came out here for one reason. It's to do what needs to be done. You see, John, personal issues in the past have clouded everybody's decision-making on the way up to this role. But the board sees now that I have put my personal problems behind me. And they've seen clear to let me know when I want to come back and run Raw, I can do it whenever I feel like it. So, Johnny, at this time, it truly warms my heart to let you know that I wish you well in all. Last week, the Undertaker's gong hit and he walked down that ramp. And I'm not ashamed to tell you that after 20 years in this business, there's nobody else that I still get that feeling for. When that gong hits and he walks down that ramp, there's a rush for me up my spine. I get butterflies in my stomach. Still, after 20 years, I can stand in the ring with The Undertaker and I am in awe. I stand in the ring with The Undertaker, and I don't say this lightly because he's the only person in the world I would say it about. I stand before him truly humbled to be in the ring with him. But I stood here and I looked into the eyes of the dead man. And for the first time ever, there was no rush up my spine. There was no butterflies in my stomach. I wasn't in awe, and I wasn't humbled to stand in front of him. I looked the Undertaker in the eyes, and what I was sorry. I felt bad for the Undertaker. Maybe you can understand it, maybe you can't, but I know what I did to him last year. No one will ever compare to The Undertaker. His legacy will never be matched. 19-0, the most dominant force ever in the WWE. Dead man, for that reason, you challenge me to WrestleMania. Out of respect, with all my heart, I say no. I understand that it's probably not the most popular decision I've ever made. I get that, but I was in the ring with him. You weren't. You watched it. I saw it firsthand. I know what I did to him, and he just kept going. He would not let it lie. He could not. The dead man would not die. And I know if we do it again, what I have to do, I have to finish it. And he knows it too. And as I looked into his eyes Monday night, and I'm just thinking about it now, you know what? Maybe that's exactly what he wants. Maybe the Undertaker wants me to put an end to it. And I heard a saying when I was a kid, not dead, that which can eternal lie, but with strange eons, even death may die. And I didn't understand what that meant at the time, but now I do. It means that everybody, including you, Undertaker, has limits. I saw your limits last year. You saw your limits last year, and I am not going to be the guy to push you past them. This is over.
Undertaker will absolutely do anything to keep that streak alive, but JR, we know nothing lasts forever.
This is not over.
The Undertaker could not leave the ring under his own power. He was carried.
This is not over.
Only one man walked out. He was carried. He was carried. And it was me. Me. He was carried.
I will not let that be the image of me that is remembered through the ages.
It was me.
My my victory over you means nothing. Give me what is mine. Vengeance. And I will give you one more chance at immortality. This is not over.
Argument he could make against it, but they want to hear him out. So they're saying they're going to have an answer by tomorrow morning. Although, you know how slow the board is with this stuff. Hey, can I call you right back? All right, thanks.
Hey, Hunter, how you doing?
Yeah, right.
The reason I'm here, at least until tomorrow morning, is that I'm still the executive vice president of talent relations and the interim general manager of Monday Night Raw. Now, when I met with the board earlier today, and I have the utmost respect for them. They were professional. And from a humanistic standpoint, a bunch of nice people. Seem like they're gonna really be fair, you know? And whatever decision they come up with, I'll accept. And by the way, guess who's gonna be here next week? Shawn Michaels.
What?
Sean's gonna
be
here.
Sean is in the middle of nowhere hunting right now. I know that. He's not gonna be here.
He was, but I suggested to the board of directors that we give the WWE Universe what they want, and that's Shawn Michaels, the showstopper, the heartbreak kid, Mr. Main Event.
I know who he is, moron.
Okay. I also gave the board of directors a suggestion for one of the main events at the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view.
Well, what is it, Big Johnny?
John Cena versus Kane, one-on-one, in an ambulance match.
Actually, is a pretty good idea. Who gave it to you? I know you didn't think it up. Hey, is there an ambulance here tonight?
Yeah, I believe so, right out there.
Think it's got one of those little machines in it that, you know, the beep, beep, beep tells you when stuff's alive. When stuff dies, it goes beep, flatlines. Maybe we could hook your career up to it, see how long it lasts.
You're always joking around, Hunter. This week, last week. Come on, quit kidding
around. Yeah, it's funny. Maybe we could hook you up to it and see if I don't flatline you right now if you don't get out of my office. Humanistic moron.
Ladies and gentlemen, late breaking news. We just learned that the Hall of Famer, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, returns to Monday Night Raw next week to speak directly to WWE COO Triple H live in San Diego on Raw. So,
John, much like all of you, I was sitting home last week, riveted to my television set. Despite what everybody thinks, even though I live in the middle of nowhere, we still do get TV. And I, like all of you, was waiting for my best friend, Triple H, to utter those words that we all wanted to hear. I accept the challenge to The Undertaker. But like many of you, I was shocked when he didn't give it. That's when I got on the phone. I called Laurinaitis and I said, look, I gotta come out there. I gotta talk to my best friend. But then a couple days went by and then all of a sudden, it dawned on me. It dawned on me. It's like, oh, he got me. He got me and he got you. Let's face it. He's the game Triple H. He's the cerebral assassin. He's just playing the Undertaker. He's just baiting him. So really, the reason I came here tonight was to bring Triple H out here so we could all hear him tell each and every one of us that he is gonna end the Undertaker's WrestleMania undefeated streak at WrestleMania. So Triple H, it's time for you to come on down and let us hear what we want to hear.
Time.
to be here live with everybody else to hear the awesome news of you facing The Undertaker at WrestleMania. So let's hear it.
And as excited as I am to see you, Sean, I wish you would have called me if that was the only reason you came here, because I'm not going to be facing The Undertaker at WrestleMania this year. Last year, you were there, you saw what I did to The Undertaker. He left the ring for the first time ever, not under his own power. He won the battle, I won the war. We haven't seen him for a year. I know what I have to do to beat him again, Sean, to beat him. I have to end him. And like I said, I'm not willing to do that, Sean. I'm not that guy anymore.
What do you mean that's not who you are anymore? Are you telling me that you married that chick and now you became one of them? I mean, is that what you are now? You're now a sellout? I mean, albeit a corporate sellout, but a sellout nonetheless.
It's not being a sellout, Sean. It's called investing in the future. Investing in a future for all of them. You know what? Not gonna have this argument out here. You can't understand it, and that's okay. I get it. You're not in my shoes. You don't understand.
Oh, yes. That's the thing. You know, you talk about me and my ranch. Yeah, it's true. I'm a simple guy. It's very tough for me to possibly understand how much it's your deep philosophical business life happens to be. But I do know this. I do know that when a man challenges you and you back down, that makes you a coward. Walk away. Walk away, because that's what a coward does.
No, you don't understand what's going on here. You can't. You sit there on your ranch with your wife and your kids. Not a care in the world, Sean. I've got responsibilities, real life responsibilities. Like it or not, whether anybody likes it or not, and I don't give a damn if they do or not. All of this, all of it is gonna be mine. And it's my responsibility, and that responsibility weighs like a ton on my shoulders, even now. You look at The Undertaker like an opponent, and sure, for years, that's how I looked at it too. He was just someone to go through. I don't look at it that way anymore, Sean. I can't, because of that responsibility. I look at it, Undertaker as a brand that is good for business, Sean. And I can't let that brand end because it's bad for business. Sean, I am not gonna be the one to end that era. You're retired. I've got other things going on now. The Undertaker is all that's left. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna be the one to end that era for no reason. Not because they want me to. I'm not gonna do it because he wants me to end it. I'm not gonna do it to feed my own ego. I sure as hell am not gonna do it to feed your ego, because you wanna live vicariously through me to get done the things that you couldn't get done.
I want you to look me in the eye and tell me you don't wanna end the streak. I want you to look me in the eye and tell me you don't wanna end The Undertaker. Look me in the eye and tell me you don't need it. Look me in the eye and tell me you don't want it. I want you to look me in the eye and tell me no. Look me in the eye!
WrestleMania. I say no. No. I looked the Undertaker in the eyes, and what I was sorry.
This is not over. Vengeance. Not over. Vengeance. I will get what I want. Keep your pity. Give me what is mine. Immortality. Vengeance. 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 Every story has an ending.
I'm not going to be facing The Undertaker at WrestleMania this year. Sorry. He won the battle, I won the war.
Vengeance.
He won the battle, I won the war.
Vengeance.
Your denials are unacceptable. Triple H, your fate is sealed. Every story has an ending. I will write yours tonight.
For nearly a year, every passing moment of every passing day, I have lived the memory of the beating that I took at the hands of Triple H last year at WrestleMania. It has been a living hell. Not a physical hell, because the wounds have all healed. It's been a hell of uncertainty. An uncertainty that I can no longer bear. So 3 weeks ago, I came in this very ring and I challenged Triple H for one more match at WrestleMania to end the uncertainty forever. And never in my wildest nightmares would I expect the answer that I got. He said no. This has to come to an end. We are on the verge of apocalypse, the apocalypse of an era of wrestling. We, whether you like it or not, are the last of our kind. So the suit, the tie, all the corporate liabilities, they're just layers to cover up who you really are. We have to end the uncertainty.
I get it. I understand how bad you want this. Here's the thing. You're right. It is the end of an era. We are the last two of our kind, but our fate is not to end it, dead man. Our fate is to ensure that it carries on. My fate is to make sure that this business is here, that the WWE exists in the future. Your fate is what it's always been, to be the leader, to carry that torch for the next generation. To carry that torch and lead the way. I will not be the one to extinguish that flame. It's bad for business.
Hey, businessman. Then make this clear for me, because it's really been bothering me. Is it bad for business if I'm gone? Or is it bad for business that you'll be gone?
While you have spent the last year living in a supposed uncertainty, I have never been more certain of anything in my life. And I think, quite honestly, if you look inside yourself, you're really certain of it too. You're not asking me for redemption. You're not asking me for salvation. You're not asking me for a shot at vengeance. You're asking me for an end. I know what I have to do to beat you. I have to finish you. And deep down inside, it's really what you want, isn't it? You want me to put an end to it. I'm not gonna do it.
You know, Hunter, I think I just figured it out. You know that you can't do what your buddy Shawn Michaels couldn't do. Because you know, Shawn was always better than you.
You want it all to come to a head? You want an end? You got it. One more thing. We do this, we go all the way. No return. No uncertainty. No excuses. The streak ends. The era ends. You get your end. We do this. We go all the way. I will face you at WrestleMania under one condition. Hell in a Cell.
No Holds Barred defines this matchup. Two of the most honored, battle-tested veterans in all WWE are about to go one-on-one for the most survivable record in WWE, The Streak.
These two guys are the most respected guys in our industry. Two of the best ever. Zeus and Hades battling it out on Mount Olympus.
They're both warriors, they're both competitors, they're both extremely proud men.
This is as tense an atmosphere as I have ever felt anywhere. He has ravished, just been relentless on the human anatomy of The Undertaker.
I don't think the streak has ever been in this much jeopardy.
Stay up!
So many chair shots, almost hard to watch. The Undertaker's been humanized, and he's in pain.
You could see him welting and bruising. Closer and closer to the three count every time.
You felt pity for The Undertaker.
Stay down! What's wrong with you?
This is too much!
The tombstone was the moment where I thought, that's it. The streak's done.
Covered his arms over his chest and the tongue and everything at 1, 2.
When you think you're winning and the guy kicks out, you're wondering, what am I supposed to do?
Desperate times.
And the sledgehammer personifies Triple H.
He had this look on his face where, you know, he didn't really want to do it, but he knew he had to do it.
Triple H had you believing that it's going to end.
Unless you find a way to stop Undertaker's heart, he's still dangerous.
Wait! There's still life!
When Triple H wound up in the Hell's Gate, I knew it was it.
Triple H was right. He lives for the streak. It's all he's got. But he is certain that he will do everything in his power to win on that day.
It was an example of just how incredible those guys are.
The Undertaker is 19-0.
To have a match this brutal, one of the guys didn't walk away, and it was the guy who won.
He left the ring for the first time ever, not under his own power. He won the battle, I won the war.
Now, okay, look, I know several weeks ago I was pretty hard on you, all right? I mean, I threw everything but the kitchen. I threw the kitchen sink at you. I was tough. But you have to understand, I really wanted you to take that match. And, you know, it's amazing. You know, that's why you're the responsible one. I mean, it didn't matter what I said. I mean, I took every cheap shot I could. I hit you below the belt. I said things that no friend should say. I mean, we've been friends for, what, 17 years, and I went out there and I put that friendship on the line. I mean, I pushed the envelope. I pushed the limits with you, and I got to tell you, I'm amazed. You didn't buckle. You didn't waver. Ladies and gentlemen, this man is an oak. An oak, I tell you. Yes. I thought of every dirty, underhanded, despicable thing I could think of to try to talk you into taking that match, but would you do it? No. No. And you want to know why? Because you, my friend, are a man of conviction. A man of honor.
A man of integrity.
What was it you said? He was a brand and all sorts of really cool corporate stuff, but you know something? You didn't give in. I mean, let's face it. I called you a coward. Do you know something? I don't know anybody. In all the years you and I have known each other, nobody looks at Triple H and calls him a coward to his face and gets away with it. But you know something? I did, and guess what? You did nothing. It's amazing. That, my friends, that is why I say he's an oak. He's an oak. But something made you change your mind. And I gotta tell you, I gotta know what it is. I mean, because with me, he wouldn't waver. But somebody must have said something that really made you mad. Somebody must have said something to make you have some kind of revelation. Something that brought you to your knees. Something so humiliating, so degrading, that there was no way you were going to turn it down. And I got to ask you, what was it? What was it?
Sean, I just...
You know something? I don't even want you to tell me. You know what I want to do? I want to do what everybody else got to do, because, you know, I don't know if I mentioned it, but I didn't get to see it. Can we get you guys to hold the cameras, somebody in the truck? Can we get them to bring up the footage? I want to see it. I want to stand with my best friend of 17 years. I want to sit with you and the world and share this moment that made you break down and say, I can do it. Come on. Let's you and I share this together.
I'm sorry, but the answer's no.
You know, Hunter, I think I just figured it out. You know that you can't do what your buddy Shawn Michaels couldn't do. Because you know, Shawn was always better than you.
You want this? You got it. I will face you at WrestleMania under one condition: Hell in a Cell.
Sean.
So, that's all it took. The worst thing that anybody could say to you is that I am better than you.
It has nothing to do with that, Sean. I know you didn't see this live, but I know you've heard. I know you got my voicemail, but if you want me to do this in front of the whole world, I will. It's got nothing to do with whether you're better than me or I'm better than you or anything like that. Sean, I'm tired of it. I'm tired of listening to it. Do you understand me? I am tired of listening to people like The Undertaker talk behind your back saying you couldn't get the job done. I am tired of people talking behind your back saying you're a failure. I am tired of people saying that on the way out, you couldn't do it because you were never as good as you thought you were in the first place. That eats me up, Sean. Because I'm your best friend, and I'm also the guy that believes with every fiber of his being that you are the greatest in-ring performer of all time. So it kills me, it pains me beyond measure to look at you as a loser. That's why I'm gonna do it, Sean. That's why I'm gonna finish it. I am gonna end The Undertaker. I am gonna end the streak. I am gonna end an era. I am gonna do what everybody runs their mouth saying you couldn't do. I'm gonna do it for me. And just as much, buddy, I'm gonna do it for you.
Well, thanks for that. I mean, here I was. I thought we had a problem. But obviously we don't. Because like always, Triple H, in his nice suit, Triple H has got everything under control. Silly me. You know, last year, it hurt me. It hurt me more than you can possibly imagine to have to look you in the eyes and tell you you couldn't get it done. And then I sat down at WrestleMania and I watched you go out there and completely dominate The Undertaker. I watched you go out there and show the world why you're the game, why you're the cerebral assassin. I watched you go out there and beat him with nearly an inch of his life. And then you lost. And I was right. This year, at WrestleMania, Hell in a Cell, I know who's gonna win. And I'll be right again. I'm sorry, and the reason I know that is because I've been made the special referee. After everything we've been through, 20 plus years of sharing that locker room. Granted, at one time, we sat at opposite ends, but even during that time, we always had the utmost respect for one another. And let's face it, the last couple of years of my career,
you and I shared something few men share.
We did something that people will remember for all time. Something that will stand the test of time. You and I did it. But yet, you, of all people, to say things behind my back, at the very least, I figured you would have the guts to say it to my face.
Sean, what is it you want me to say? That you're a failure? A loser? Or is it that you couldn't get the job done? I think you need to stop and think. Are you repeating my words? Or maybe, just maybe, you're repeating the words chosen for me by your good friend, Triple H. Whatever the case may be, you need to let all your little insecurities.
What? My insecurities? My insecurities? I got news for you. You're the one that asked for this match. I mean, you kidding me? You practically begged for this match. Here you sit at 19-0, and you still feel like you got something to prove. You're still the one in search of validation. And you want to know why? It's because you know it, and I know it. Last year, Triple H beat you within an inch of your life. That's why last week, I looked at him, and I told him, I know who's going to win.
You know, Sean, so it is. But I think you should know, whatever happens at WrestleMania, whether I win or I should happen to lose, I'm prepared to accept the outcome. But what I'm not prepared to accept is you sticking your ego in this. Our two matches at WrestleMania, the match last year with Triple H, it's all been destiny. You see, what can't happen is for the outcome, win or lose, to not be pure. And if the outcome isn't pure, I promise you, there will be hell to pay.
You know something? You call all this destiny. I look at it as irony. Isn't it ironic that the guy whose career you ended can quite possibly be the guy who counts your shoulders to the mat? Isn't it ironic that I'm the guy who could possibly turn you into a loser? Turn you into a failure and show you couldn't get it done. Isn't it ironic that I could still be the guy to possibly end the streak?
I will beat Triple H in the cell. The streak will continue, and I will officially end an era. But if you don't do the right thing, I will officially end you.
To know what's old HBK's prediction on this match. Well, got news for you. You're gonna have to wait for WrestleMania, but I will give you my opinion on what I think is going to happen. First thing everybody wants to know is, can I be an impartial referee? I mean, considering my 17-year friendship with Triple H, can I be impartial? But before I answer that, Undertaker, let's be honest. The end of an era, you know as well as I do, that's just code for the end of the streak. The fact of the matter is, I've been where you've been. I've stood in your shoes. 2 short years ago, I stood there and I saw the end. And I knew that it was inevitable. And you, Undertaker, are in the same place. There you stand. Look, before you
Sean,
even
start.
You did enough talking last week. Right now, it would be in your best interest to shut up and listen. I've already told you that this match has to remain pure. So before you and your buddy start making plans to
You need to stop worrying about him. Because as much as Sean's ego wants this to be about him, it's not. It's about me and you. It's always been about me and you. Like you said, it's our destiny to do this. Two parallel legendary careers running side by side, connected by one thing. The most demonic structure in WWE history, Hell in a Cell. There have been 24 Hell in a Cell matches since the beginning, just 24. You and I have been in 19 of them. It's not a coincidence. It's not a coincidence that the match that started out as the Devil's Playground became my proving ground. It's where I learned that if it didn't kill me, it made me stronger. It's where I learned how to push the limits of human endurance. It's where I learned what it takes to end another man's career. It's where I thrive. It's where I excel. All those matches, all of them, everything I've been through have been for one moment. April 1st, WrestleMania. Hell in a Cell. The whole world is gonna see the end of an era. Yours. And don't worry. I know exactly what it is going to take inside that hell to finish the job.
You? Are you sure? Your mind, your body, your soul, your career, your wife, your kids. All this, even your life, are you willing to put it all on the line?
If it means giving you the end that you so richly deserve, then I am. And I will.
You remember when I said Sean is better than you? He is.
About him, it's not. I am gonna end
The Undertaker. I am gonna end the streak. I am gonna end an era.
Everything I've been through, I've been for one moment. WrestleMania.
Your mind, your body, your soul, all this. Are you willing to put it all on the line?
I am. And I will.